All right, I guess that answers Mahesh Jethmalani's point. But I want to get your sense about this whole Pakistan question, because at the end of the day, that's what this boils down to, this case, doesn't it, Mr. Nickam? Irrespective of what happens here with the trial and the subsequent confirmation now by the Bombay High Court and hopefully in the future from the Supreme Court, the fact is, unless the trial in Pakistan takes off and reaches some kind of logical conclusion, the masterminds, the big conspirators of the dastardly attack will still continue to roam free.
Now, today the High Court has given clear-cut finding that Kassab himself, on his own, he had joined the criminal conspiracy. Kassab is also the principal offender behind the terror attack. And the High Court has given the clear finding. Of course, I have not read the entire text of the judgment. I can't say now at the juncture. But the co-conspirator against whom the trial is pending in the Pakistan, that is equally important trial for us, because they also must be punished. But now it is for the Pakistan how to proceed expeditiously against them.
Okay. I want to go to Mahesh Jethmalani about a point that Dr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi said before the break about, I mean, let's look at it dispassionately. Yes, as right-thinking Indians, we're all outraged by what happened in Mumbai, the aftermath of it. And everyone will say that this process had to be brought to a logical conclusion as fast as possible. It's pretty much an open and shut case. The world knows that Kassab is a terrorist. But if you look at it dispassionately, what could the government possibly have done rather than exerting pressure? We weren't talking to Pakistan for 2.5 years since this attack happened. And only recently has the decision been taken to talk to Pakistan, because let's be dispassionate and objective about it. What is the leverage that we have over another country?
Look, Zaka, I am not saying that, you know, Dr. Singhvi posits an absurd alternative to putting pressure on Pakistan. Nobody's saying go to war with Pakistan. Nobody suggests that at all. All we are saying is there was a consensus after 26/11 that unless terrorism, the terrorists were brought to book, the perpetrators of 26/11 were brought to book, and unless Pakistan ceased to spawn terrorism from its soil, there would be no dialogue with it. Now, but that has been watered down.
Isn't that a little unrealistic? How can you not talk to a neighbor? I mean, for better or for worse, like the government says, you can't choose your neighbors. You've got to live with them.
I am sorry. No, you can't choose your neighbor, but you can certainly choose to ignore your neighbor. We are wasting time talking to Pakistan, because Pakistan is just not intent on all you say. All you say, look, forget it. We accept the Qureshi line. Qureshi says India should move on from 26/11. Now, he's adding insult to injury. Not only will he not bring the perpetrators to book, but he's actually advising us to erase from our memory 26/11. The ex-foreign minister of Pakistan, Mr. Qureshi.
Okay.
Now, if you want to take those insult to injury, I would say that enough is enough. And there is no point talking to these people, because they are incorrigible. They are not
Do you want to respond to that? The fact is, for whatever the government of India says, for 2.5 years, we haven't talked to Pakistan.
I've heard him. Yeah.
Go on.
Two or three quick points.
Yeah.
First of all, any objective and non-biased observer would say that never in the history since the formation of India and Pakistan has Pakistan been so isolated, so finger-pointed, and so shamed globally as it has been in the aftermath of 26/11. Pakistan is seen by all the countries that matter as a rogue state on this front. Pakistan has admitted, I repeat the word admitted, that Kassab is a Pakistani national. Pakistan has virtually admitted that other elements were supporting Kassab from Pakistani soil. And Pakistan is trying to do a trial, although certainly not doing it sincerely. Now, the gains are the gains because of a very concerted Indian policy globally and domestically, a holistic policy which has shaped Pakistan into action. And let me tell you that apart from being in the opposition and sensationalizing, nobody could have done better. Point number two is very important. Did Mr. Vajpayee sit in a corner and sulk when no less than a Kargil war happened for months and months and months? No. Contrary to what Mr. Jethmalani tells us, he took a bus yatra. Did he sit and sulk after Agra failed? And remember, he had Agra after Kargil. After Kargil. No. Did he sit and sulk after the parliament attack? No. this government has in fact been much more effective from 2004 in shaming Pakistan into action. Let me remind Mr. Jethmalani that Musharraf, after both Kargil and parliament attack, did not give any of the kind of concessions we have extracted from Pakistan.